It's been a seesaw session this Thursday afternoon right here at the New York Stock Exchange as U.S. stocks continue to trade lower as investors take in more earnings and second quarter GDP. This all just one day after the U.S. Federal Reserve left its interest rates unchanged. Now yesterday, the central bank keeping rates unchanged and giving no hint of liftoff coming in the next meeting. The decision on the rates was unanimous. Meanwhile, shifting focus to today's session, we have seen a ton of activity in the economic front. We had the Commerce Department saying that GDP expanded at an annual rate of 2.3%. That was slightly below expectations. And the U.S. weekly jobless claims report that increased by 12,000 week over week, but that too came in below expectations, 267,000. Now, in a quick market recap, the Dow Jones Industrial Average last trading down about 73 points. That's a little more than 0.4% with Procter & Gamble, the greatest laggard, and United Technologies leading the advancers. The S&P 500 trading down about 9 points, about 0.4%, to last trade at 2,099, with healthcare leading 7 sectors lower and utilities the best performer. And the Nasdaq last trading 23 points lower, just under 0.5% at 5,088. Now shifting focus across the pond, the FTSE 100 rising for a third straight session, with energy shares leading the way following stronger oil prices and a rally in Shell after it announced jobs and spending cuts. Now, Royal Dutch Shell led the energy sector higher, with its shares rising nearly 5% after the company said it would cut a total of 6,500 jobs this year and also increase more spending cuts. The blue chip FTSE 100 index last up 0.6%, 6,670.42 just before the market close, and this after touching a one-week high of 6,697.40. And in the other markets, that's where we conclude the U.S. dollar trading more than 0.5% higher against its major counterparts, with the euro at about $1.09. Crude oil futures for September delivery rising 14 cents to $48.94 a barrel over at the New York Mercantile Exchange, and gold futures down $4.10 to $10.88.50 a troy ounce in late afternoon trade. And with that stated, I'm James Sweeney, special correspondent for Atos Web TV.